Strength in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. To God be all the glory, great things He has done. Father Lord, I want to thank you. I want to give you praise. I lift up your name on high, for you are wonderful. I thank you so much for your faithfulness. I thank you for your love. I thank you for your mighty power. I thank you for in you we live, we move, and we have our being. Thank you for this very wonderful and precious day. Father, be thou glorified this hour in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Lord, I commit this hour before you. Have your way in the name of Jesus. Holy Spirit, take control in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you, ever living Father. Thank you for the wonderful new month that we've entered. Lord, it's going to be a month of joy, month of grace, month of testimonies in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. To you that be all the glory, O God. Your word and not my word, Daddy. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. Hallelujah. To God be all the glory, great things He has done. Happy new month. Hallelujah. The month of November. We appreciate the Lord. We give God all the glory. That's power that is going on in the world. We're still celebrating a new month. Hallelujah. A Lord, and we're not given the privilege to do that. But I just want to appreciate the Lord concerning my life, your life, our families, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. What a mighty God we serve. Hallelujah. Sunday online. The last time we did that was a couple of months ago during the first lockdown. That was about for 3 months then. It was probably in the month of March, April, May. Hallelujah. But we bless the Lord. London has been on lockdown since Friday, but we're having a severe lockdown this very Thursday. From this very Thursday, there's going to be a severe lockdown, totally lockdown. Hallelujah. We will be given the privilege to come back again on the 1st of December. The same thing as well in France. They are on total lockdown as well, and they are coming back the 1st of December, the first week in the month of December. But irrespective of that, God is God in our lives, God is God in my life, and God is God in your life in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Hallelujah. Introduction to greatness. That is what I want to actually minister on, of which we're going to pray, because normally we will I'll minister and we'll pray. Hallelujah. I still have a program on Wednesday, this coming Wednesday. Hallelujah. this coming Wednesday concerning the fasting and prayer. And this Sunday as well, we're going to pray as well, concerning this very fasting and prayer as well. We are still on the same belt, under the same belt of this 70 days fasting and prayer. And I know God in His infinite mercy is with you and I in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. A lot that are fasting, I appreciate God concerning your life. And those who are not, this very hour, I thank God even for your life as well. And I know God will continue to be God in my life and in your life in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. On Wednesday, that is going to be the 24th day. Hallelujah. The 24th day of our fasting and prayer. Today is the 21, 23, 24. Yeah. 21, 22, 23. Yeah. Today is the 21st. Hallelujah. So on Wednesday, it's going to be the 24th day of our fasting and prayer. And we're still going to 70. Hallelujah. So we appreciate the Lord. And to those that are fasting right now, Jehovah will come to strengthen you, uphold you in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. God said this can only be done through fasting and prayer. And whatever you are asking the Lord for, Jehovah will honor you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. But just an hour, hallelujah, an hour, I just want to minister the word of the Lord, hallelujah, which is going to benefit every single one of us. And it's going to bring a change into our life, a new growth in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Showers of blessing, testimonies upon our life in the name of Jesus. The word says introduction to greatness. Hallelujah. Introduction to greatness. One thing about greatness in life, God wants to take us through a particular journey in life. Hallelujah. The journey might be that very difficult in our sight, but to God it is not. Hallelujah. God wants to take us through a journey into greatness this very morning. Hallelujah. And this journey is going to benefit every single man, every single woman this very hour in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. But the question is, are you really ready? Hallelujah. Are you really ready? If you're ready for this very journey, I know it's going to be of benefit, great benefit to you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. That will bring you into a total turnaround. Hallelujah. Abraham went through this very journey. It became very, very wonderful. The Bible says, and God called Abraham my friend. Hallelujah. Sarah went through this journey. Jacob also went through this journey. So it's your time and it's your turn as well to go through this very journey. Hallelujah. The journey might be so tensed, but let me tell you, favor is there with you. His grace is always there with you, because that's the journey that want to test your faith in God. Hallelujah. So today, this very afternoon, God wants to actually take you and I on this very wonderful journey. Hallelujah. And never be afraid to trust an unknown future. Hallelujah. To a known God. Hallelujah. You'll never be afraid to trust an unknown future to a known God, because our God is good. Hallelujah. The future might be unknown to you, but we're actually placing this unknown future to a known God. Hallelujah. And God gave us the gift of life. Every man, every woman that is watching me right now, I want to tell you, it is a privilege for this very wonderful gift of life. God gave us this very gift of life. Hallelujah. And it's to us to give ourselves the gift of living as well. Hallelujah. We have this gift of life, but it is our duty also to give ourselves the gift of living well. Hallelujah. And I know that by the special reason, by the special power of the Most High God, every single man, because you have been given the gift of life, today I want to tell you, you have the right to give yourself the gift of living. And I know by the special grace of God, you will be great in life in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. As many that are watching me and hearing me right now, you will be great in life in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. We have to go through this very uncomfortable place. Hallelujah. And that's this journey into greatness. It's an uncomfortable place. Hallelujah. Or places, but its favor is still going to be on ground. Hallelujah. When we embark on this very journey, it's an uncomfortable place, but its favor will still be on ground. Hallelujah. It's a divine training that comes with purpose and attainment. Hallelujah. This journey comes with it's a divine purpose in life that comes with attainment. That the word attainment is you attaining your purpose in life. It's you getting what God has actually given to you. Hallelujah. But there are processes concerning it. Hallelujah. So it's a divine training that comes with purpose and attainment. And I know by the special grace of God, everyone that is watching me right now, you are going to fulfill purpose in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. You are going to fulfill purpose in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And this journey will take you through the valley of the shadow of death. Hallelujah. This journey, I want to repeat again, this journey will take you through the valley of the shadow of death. But one thing the Bible says, you fear no evil. And the reason for that, because his favor will still be on ground. The favor of the Lord will follow you and will be with you in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. But before we go into the prayer for this very hour concerning our fasting and prayer, I want to actually go through certain verses, scriptures in the book of the Bible with you in Genesis chapter 37. I want to quickly read. I want to tell you those who actually went through this very journey and the favor of God actually guided them through, and they excel in this very journey. Number one is Joseph. Genesis chapter 37. I want to read verse 5. I'll be jumping verses and I'll make it as snappy, as quick as possible. Hallelujah. Genesis chapter 37. I want to read verse 5. Now Joseph had a dream, and he told his brothers, and they hated him even more. Hallelujah. This journey that you are going to go through, a lot will know about this journey in life, but honestly, if you are not careful enough, they must stop this very journey. And I know today, by the special grace of God, the journey that you are embarking on this very hour is a journey that God wants to introduce you into greatness. So the Bible says, now Joseph had a dream, and he told his brothers, and they hated him even more. In verse 10, so he told to his father and his brothers, and his father rebuked him and said to him, even the father rebuked him, hallelujah, and said to him, what is this dream that you have dreamed? Shall your mother and I and your brothers indeed come to bow to the ground before you? Hallelujah. These are purposes in life. In verse 11, and his brothers envied him. So his father kept the matter in his mind. Not that the father did not actually understand this very dream. The father understood this very dream quite well, but he kept it in his mind in order to shield him from the brother. But he actually told the brothers his dream. So the envy was so much intense. Hallelujah. A number of you, honestly, go and mark it out. As you are engaging into this very introduction to greatness, you are actually moving towards it. A lot of hatred will come, but don't let that hold you down in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. In verse 19, then they said to one another, look, this dreamer is coming. Hallelujah. When Joseph was actually going to meet his brother, they saw him from afar and they said, look, the dreamer is coming. A number of people might be looking at you as a dreamer, but you have a purpose. Hallelujah. And the purpose is introduction into greatness. God wants to introduce you to greatness. It doesn't matter what you're going through right now, the introduction is going to be great, it's going to be wonderful, it's going to be divine in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And in verse 20, the Bible said, come thereof, when they said, look at this dreamer, look, the dreamer is coming. They now said, come thereof, let us now kill him and cast him into pits. Hallelujah. We shall see wild beasts as devoured him. And hear what they said in the verse and the very paragraph here. We shall see what will become his dreams. Hallelujah. Today there are people who are waiting what will become your dream. And one thing about dreams in life, it is your life, it is your purpose. Hallelujah. Like I said earlier on, God gave us the gift of life. Hallelujah. But it's up to us to give ourselves the gift of living. Hallelujah. So they said to him, let us see what will become his dream. We need to give ourselves the gift of living. God gave us the gift of life, and we must give ourselves the gift of living. They said, let us see what will become of his dream. Today I want to tell you, this very hour, your dream is going to be great. Your dream is going to be bigger than whatever you ever imagined in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And in verse 24, they took him and cast him into the pit. Hallelujah. And the pit was empty, and there was no water in it. Hallelujah. Number one P. Hallelujah. They put him in the pit. Hallelujah. They thought, okay, let us kill him. Let's so that the beast would devour him. Hallelujah. So they kept him in the pit. Hallelujah. If you are being kept in the pit right now, these are introduction into greatness. Hallelujah. And one thing I want to tell you, the favor of the Lord, the grace of God is still with you. Hallelujah. It's still with you. Yea, when I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, God said, I fear no evil. That's the grace of God is still with you. When it was kept in the first P as in letter P, that is the pit. Hallelujah. And in verse 28, the Bible says, the Midianite traders passed by, so the brothers pulled Joseph up and lifted him out of the pit, and sold according to Ishmaelite, hallelujah, of 20 shekel of silver, and they took Joseph to Egypt. Hallelujah. Imagine, they sold their brother because of his dream. And the one thing about life is that they never even look at it or sit down and reason within themselves, even if the brother's dream is going to favor them later on in life. Hallelujah. They don't want to listen to that because envy was on ground. Whoever is envying you right now, because you are actually in the pit. Hallelujah. When you sit in darkness, the Bible says the Lord will be your light. Hear me well. Favor is always there. When God is taking you into introduction into greatness, favor is always there. Grace is always supporting. Hallelujah. And in Genesis chapter 39, when you study from verse 3, I want to quickly read. And his master saw that the Lord was with him, and that the Lord made him all, the Lord made all he did to prosper in his land. Hear me well. When he was sold in Genesis chapter 39, the man that actually bought him now saw that, wow, this boy, the Lord is just with him. And imagine, even keeping Joseph in his house, the master prospered because of Joseph. And in verse 4, so Joseph found favor in his sight. You see, favor will always be there. When you're going through introduction into greatness, favor is always standing, and grace is always supporting, and grace is an unmerited favor. That's it's more or less the word Esther means grace, our favor. So favor is always on ground. So in verse 4, so Joseph found favor in the sight of his master. It doesn't matter where you are being kept this very hour, favor is always on ground. The grace of God is always present. Hallelujah. And the grace of God is will always be and abide with you, because at this very hour you are going into introduction into greatness. You're actually moving into greatness right now. I'm not talking about just an ordinary greatness. I'm talking about a divine greatness in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And the Bible says, so Joseph found favor in his sight. Hallelujah. And served him, then made him overseers of his house. Hallelujah. And all he had, he put under his authority. He had this very well. The master that actually bore him put everything under Joseph's authority. But something actually came out as well in the same Genesis. Hallelujah. When we study from 20 to 21, then Joseph's master took him and put him in prison. Joseph had a word with the master's wife about, we all know that the woman wanted Joseph to sleep with her, but Joseph refused, and the woman actually reported and lied against him. And in verse 39, the Bible says, then Joseph's master took him and put him in the prison. Hallelujah. That is the second P. Hallelujah. They put him in the prison from the pit. Hallelujah. That these are journey into introduction into greatness. The first P, they put him in prison, in the pit. The second P is in the prison. Hallelujah. And the master put him in prison, a place where the king's prisoners were confirmed. Hallelujah. Confined. Hallelujah. He was there in the prison, but the Lord was with Joseph and showed him mercy, and he gave him favor. You see, again, anywhere when you're actually on that very journey into greatness, favor, grace is always on ground. Hallelujah. Because no matter what, the presence and the protection of God will always be on you. Hallelujah. But the Lord was with Joseph and showed him his mercy. Hallelujah. So God is going to show you mercy this very hour. If you're actually taken out from the pit into the prison right now, I'm not talking about a physical prison, I'm talking about a spiritual prison. Even if it's a physical prison, the favor of God will be with you, and mercy will be with you. And he gave him favor in the sight of the keeper of the prison. Hallelujah. Joseph got to Egypt at the age of 17. Hear me well. He got to Egypt at the age of 17, and Joseph was in prison for 13 years. Hallelujah. Imagine that, he was in prison for 13 years. I will go further later on. He got into Egypt, they sold him at the age of 17, they took him to Egypt at the age of 17, and he was in prison for 13 solid years. But I want to go further, I will go back on that. Hallelujah. So from the first P to the second P and the third P right now, in Genesis chapter 41, when you study from 38 to 45, the Bible says, and Pharaoh said to his servant, can we find such one that is a man who in whom the spirit of God is? Then Pharaoh said to Joseph, inasmuch as God has shown you all this, there is no one as discerning and wise as you. You shall be he shall be over my house. Pharaoh was telling this, and all the people shall be ruled according to your word. You see now, when Joseph actually translated the dream, hallelujah, and the dream was wonderful. It was God actual divine translation from the throne of God. Hallelujah, that Joseph actually gave Pharaoh. And Pharaoh now said, you shall be over my house, and all the people shall be ruled according to your word. Only in regards to truth throne, I will be greater than you. So in a nutshell, everything you want to do in Egypt, you are being given the power to do it, but only in regards to throne. I will be the king, but you go ahead and continue to do whatever you want to do. He said, only in regards to of the throne, I will be greater than you. And Pharaoh said to Joseph, see, I have set you over all the land of Egypt. Then Pharaoh took his signet, the ring that he was wearing, off his hand and put it on Joseph's hand, and he clothed him in garment of fine linen and put a gold chain around his neck, and he said, and he had his him ride in the second chariot which he had, and they cried out before him, bowed the knee. And so he set him over all the land of Egypt. Pharaoh also said to Joseph, I am Pharaoh. You see that? He said, I am Pharaoh, and without your consent no man lifts his hand or foot in all the land of Egypt. You see, he gave him all. Hallelujah. No man should lift his foot in the land of Egypt without Joseph's consent. And Pharaoh called Joseph Zephanad Piriam, and he gave him a wife, Asenath, the daughter of Potiphera, priest of On. So Joseph went out over all the land of Egypt. So the first P was in the pit, the second was in the prison, and the third was in the palace. Hear me very well. God wants to take you to this very journey. Hallelujah. So no matter what you're going through right now, I want to tell you, it might be that you are in the first P or you are in the second P, but go and mark it down. You are going to enter into the third P, which is the palace. People will favor you. Kings will know you. Mercy will come down. Grace will be sufficient enough for you in all that you do, in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Hear me very well. I am not just joking. God started it, and God actually ended it. God ended with grace, with divine favor upon Joseph. The same divine favor is coming upon your life. So irrespective of the P that you are in right now, it might be the first one, it might be the second one, but I am assuring you this very hour, if you don't get tired, because I know the strength of the Lord is always upon your person, and when the strength of God comes upon your person, go and mark it out. You are able to run with horses. Hallelujah. Because the Bible says, if you run with footmen and you get weary, how can you contend with horses? And know when the grace of God comes upon your life, you are not only running with footmen, you are actually contending with horses this very hour. Today, I want to tell you, you might be in the first P or in the second P, but don't worry. The third P awaits you. You are entering into the third P, and that third P brings you into introduction into greatness. Whereby all nations will honor you. Whereby all nations will bless you. So Joseph was actually sold to the Potiphar's house at the age of 17. Hallelujah. And he was in prison for 30 years. 17 plus 13 years is 30 years old. Joseph became second in command in an unknown country. Hallelujah. A country that wasn't his own country. He became special there. Hallelujah. So I want to tell you this very hour, hear me very well. Yet though you walk through the valley of the shadow of death, God said, you fear no evil. He said, I will be with you. So the grace and the mercy of God is always there with you. Well, God wants to take you through an uncomfortable place. Hallelujah. In order to favor you. That is one thing about God. God wants to take you to an uncomfortable. So never be afraid to trust an unknown future to a known God. Joseph trusted his unknown future to a known God. So I want to tell you this very morning, by the special grace of God, you are entering into the last P, which is the palace, and nations will know you. Hallelujah. Those who despise you will come before you and beg you. Hallelujah. Because you are going to be glowing, and you're going to be empowered and going to be covered by the power of the Most High God, because an unmerited favor that is the grace of God is upon your life. And the second person, before we go into prayer, I will not even go all up to an hour. Hallelujah. Because I know for sure that your divine understanding is actually focusing on the attention of the Lord right now, in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I know that your heart right now is with the Lord, because the Bible says man looks at the outward appearance, but God sees the heart. I know God is seeing your heart right now. I know God is actually moving you into the last P, which is the palace. I know you are going to dine with kings, as the same thing God actually moved Mephibosheth to the last P. He suffered from the first P, the second P, but he dined with the king. He dined with David. You are going to dine with the king. The second person I want to share with you right now is David. Hallelujah. But we look at David in 1 Samuel chapter 16 in verse 11. David in 1 Samuel chapter 16 in verse 11. And David and Saul said to Jesse. Saul was actually instructed by God to go to Jesse's house. Hear me very well. There's somebody that's watching me right now. The power of the Lord actually sighted you. The power of the Lord is upon your life this very hour to recognize you for greater things in life. In the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. The power of the Lord sighted you this very hour. Is seeing you this very hour. That is recognized you for lifting this very hour. In the mighty name of the Lord Jesus. In 1 Samuel chapter 16, here we're in verse 11. And Saul said to Jesse, "Are all the young men here?" Then he said, "There remains yet the youngest, and there he is, keeping the sheep." And Samuel said to Jesse, "Send and bring him, for we will not sit down until he comes." Today, by the special grace of God, they actually kept David in the first pea, hallelujah, where he belongs. They thought this brother is going to wine and dine with sheep forever. They thought this brother is going to be rejected, dejected, oppressed, and whatever forever. But the plan of God concerning his life is of good. Hear me well. The plan of God concerning your life this very hour is of good and not of evil, to give you a hope and a future. Hallelujah. And I know today, by the special grace of God, your future is divinely clear. This very hour, you are attaining purpose. You, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, you are moving into greater heights in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Go and mark it out. Greater heights, that's where you are moving into this very hour, in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. In the same 1 Samuel chapter 6, I want to read chapter 16. Hallelujah. The same 1 Samuel chapter 16, I read 18 and 22 to 23. Hallelujah. Then one of the servants said and said, "Look, I have seen a son of Jesse." This very chapter is when when Saul actually had a little bit of mental problem. That's what I would call it. He had a little bit of mental problem. So he was actually looking for someone that can play a harp. Hallelujah. Like a tambourine for him, so that the madness would actually come down. Hallelujah. So they now look for somebody. He guess who they found? They found David as well. Hallelujah. Guess who they found? Hallelujah. They found David that was in feeding the sheep. They found David. And in the Bible says, then one of the servants answered and said, "Look, I have seen a son of Jesse in Bethlehem who is skillful in playing." You see, David has got all. The moment, hear me very, everyone that is watching me right now, you've got all that it takes to be somebody in life. Hallelujah. God has given you the life that a life to live. You must be able to live your life well. Hallelujah. So they said, we see somebody who is skillful in playing, a mighty man of valor. Hallelujah. David had never fought a war, but they called him a mighty man of valor. Hear me very well, everyone that is watching me right, you, whether you're a man or a woman, you are mighty men, a mighty woman of valor, in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And they now said, yeah, they said, a man of war. Imagine, a man of war. David has never fought war here, and they called him a man of war. Hallelujah. In a nutshell, this servant actually saw, God actually opened his eyes to see the potentials and the gift of God in the life of David. Hallelujah. The man actually said, a skillful play. He plays very skillfully. Hallelujah. A mighty man of valor, a man of war, prudent in speech. Hallelujah. And a handsome person like me. Hallelujah. A handsome person, and the Lord is with him. You see that again? And the Lord, the word, and the Lord is with him. More or less, the grace of God is upon his life. So favor is always standing when you are going through certain things. Favor is always standing. Hallelujah. And in 22 to 23, then Saul sent to Jesse saying, "Please let David stand before me, for he has favor in my sight." Imagine this. Saul has never seen David, but favor came upon the life of David. Hear me very well. It doesn't matter the pit that you are in right now. The favor of the Lord is presently upon your side, or in your life right now, in the name of Jesus. So it was, whenever the Spirit of God was upon Saul, that David would play a harp and play it with his hand, then Saul will come refreshed and well, and the distressing spirit upon him will depart. Hallelujah. So in this very chapter, it was favor. Hallelujah. So the next chapter, David also became an errand boy. It doesn't matter what the process that you are going through right now, you can go into the merry clay, but the hands of God is going to pick you out. In 1 Samuel chapter 17, when he studied 17 and 18, he became an errand boy. Hallelujah. A number of you, what you are going through right now, you want to say, no, you cannot talk to me like that. Do you know who I am? You are nobody this very precious time. Hallelujah. Until subjection comes, until humility comes, until you are down totally. David became an errand boy. In 1 Samuel chapter 17, when he studied 17 and 18, listen to this. Then Jesse said to his son, Jesse the father sent to David, his son David, "Take now to your brothers and Ephraim and these dry grains and these 10 loaves hallelujah, and run to the brother at the camp. They were in the camp facing Goliath at that very hour, and carry these 10 cheese to the captains of thousand, and see how your brothers fear, and bring back good news, or bring back news to them. Hallelujah. Imagine this. He became an errand boy. The father actually sent him out. But hear me very well. The message of his father, this very particular message right now, triggered the grace upon the life of Joseph, of David. This message actually pushed David into the third P. Hallelujah. Hear me very, I want to repeat again. This very message pushed David into the third P. Hallelujah. David was never to be in the on the war front, but the father actually sent him onto the war front to go and actually deliver an errand, a boy, the little boy, go and do this. But he went, and this very message actually gave him courage. He was courageous and he was bold before the king. So when he got to the camp in 1 Samuel chapter 17, when you study 34 to 36, how quickly we, because we need to pray. In 1 Samuel chapter 17, when you study 34 to 36, he had this. But David said to Saul, your servant used, because Saul looked at David and said, you want to fight Goliath, you are a small boy, you cannot do that. We have warlords that are here, those who are trained for war. But David said to Saul, your servant used to keep his father's sheep, and when a lion or bear came and took a lamb out of the flocks, I went after it, I struck it, and delivered the lamb from its mouth. And when it arose again, I caught it by the bears and struck and killed it. Imagine, a bear is more or less about 10-15 feet. Hallelujah. And the claws are so powerful, where a slap of a bear can actually kill. Hallelujah. Your servant has killed both lion and bear, and these uncircumcised Philistines will be like one of them. Hallelujah. Seeing he defied the armies of the living God, as David was moving, David also trusted in the Lord. Hallelujah. When he had that Goliath defied the armies of the living God. Those who are watching me right now, you have been amongst your friends, you have been in a group whereby a lot of number of your friends are not believers, and they say something contrary to the Lord you serve, and you cannot alter a word. They say contrary things to the Lord you serve. They say contrary things about your ministry. They say contrary things about what you believe in. And you cannot alter a word. Hallelujah. David was not a warlord, but when he got to the battlefield, he had Goliath saying things that were not okay. All other armies were here wearing this, but they were comfortable. Hallelujah. With it, they were comfortable because they were afraid. But it was never okay. He said, how can I see this one defy the armies of the living God? And in verse Samuel chapter 17 in verse 51, hear me very well. Therefore David ran and stood over the, when actually used the sling on him, Goliath fell down. But in 1751, and therefore David ran and stood over the Philistine, took his sword and drew it out his sheath, and killed him. Hallelujah. And cut off his head with it. And when the Philistines saw that their champions were dead, they fled. Hallelujah. Imagine this. When David was introduced, hallelujah, David entered into another realm of supernatural. You are entering into another realm of supernatural this very hour, in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And look at what actually befell David in 1 Samuel chapter 18 in verse 7. The women gathered together because they could see a king like in the life of David. They could see the nature of a king in the life of David, what they never saw in Saul. And the women gathered in 1 Samuel chapter 18 in verse 7. This, the women said, so the women sang and danced, and they said, Saul slain in thousands and David in 10,000. An introduction into greatness occurred here. An introduction into greatness occurred here. Today, by the special grace of God, an introduction into greatness will occur in your life in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. With that very song, hallelujah, an introduction into greatness came upon the life of David, because the present king, they said, he is slain in thousands and David in 10,000. An introduction into greatness came into this very hour. In that very hour, in 1 Samuel chapter 18 in verse 21, Saul wanted to kill David because of this. So Saul said, I will give her to him. Hallelujah. Saul wanted to give his daughter to David. He said, I will give her to him, that she may be a snare to him, and that the hands of the Philistines may be against him. Therefore Saul gave to David a second time, you shall be my son-in-law. You see, he actually wanted to put David on a snare. Hallelujah. A trap. Hallelujah. So he wanted to kill David, but we bless the Lord for the life of David. So in 1 Samuel chapter 21 in verse 9, he had this very well. David was more or less walking around in the other P, the second P, and this second P was more or less a spiritual prison in the life of David. David, when Saul wanted to kill him, David ran away from that very area, and David was more or less dejected, wandering around. But he came into the land of the Philistines. Hallelujah. When he came there in 1 Samuel chapter 21 in verse 9, and he went there, he went before the king, he requested for his sword. Hallelujah. He heard this very well. He requested for his sword in the land of the Philistines. He actually killed the Goliath of Philistines, and he went to Philistines and he requested for his sword. In 1 Samuel chapter 21, when the grace of God is upon your life, people no longer see you. They see God in you. The Bible says, Christ in me, the hope of glory. So the priest said, the sword of Goliath the Philistines, whom you killed in the valley of Elah, there it is, wrapped in a cloth behind the ephod. If you will take that, take it, for there is no other order except that one. No other sword except that one. And David said, this is not like it. Give it to me, you know. His sword was kept. Hallelujah. The sword he used in killing Goliath was actually kept for him in the land of Goliath. Hallelujah. You see, God will always guide and protect you. Today, to as many that are watching me this very hour, Jehovah will guide and protect you in the mighty name of the Lord God. David became a king at the age of 30. 17 years when he was sold, 13 years in prison. In 2 Samuel chapter 2 in verse 4, I will quickly round up. 2 Samuel chapter 2 in verse 4, then the men of Judah came, and they anointed David king over the house of Judah. And they told David, saying, the men of Jabesh Gilead was the one who buried Saul when Saul died. David reigned for 40 years. David reigned for 40 years. Hallelujah. In 1 Kings chapter 2 in verse 11, the period that David reigned over Israel was for 40 years. 7 years he reigned in Hebron, and in Jerusalem he reigned 33 years. So all the years of David was 70 years when he died. But hear me well, in 1 Samuel chapter 2 in verse 1, 1 Kings chapter 2 in verse 1, now the days of David drew near that he should die, and he charged Solomon his son, saying, this is very important. I'm not saying that anyone will die this very hour, but make sure, train your child in the way of the Lord, that when he grow, he will not depart from it. Hallelujah. David actually charged his son, and he charged him to go in the way of the Lord. It is very, very important. Hear me very well. Trust God. Hallelujah. Trust God, that God can grant you your desired need in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Jehovah can grant you your desired need in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. The more we abide in Christ, the more his grace and power transform us into his image. Hallelujah. Hear me very well. We want to go into prayer this very hour. Trust God to grant you the needed grace. Hallelujah. And strength to overcome every situation in your life. You are going through 1st P right now. Probably you are in the 1st P or in the 2nd P. Hear me very well. The third one is great. The third one is introducing into greatness. All that you are going through right now is more or less a divine introduction into greatness. It doesn't matter what you are going through right now. God wants to show you something that is good. God wants to actually bring you into the land that flows with milk and honey, a position whereby people will look at you and say, this can only be God. And when God favors you, no amount of failure can bring you down. Hear me very well. And I know this very hour, favor is coming upon everyone's life. God favored Joseph in the house of Potiphar. God favored Joseph in the prison. God favored Joseph before Pharaoh, and God favored David as well. Samuel came to Jesse, God favored him when he was actually paying the app for Saul. God favored him when he went to give his brothers food. God favored him before the king, and God favored him before Goliath, and God even favored him with the same sword he used in killing Goliath. So hear me very well. I want to tell you, when the favor of God is upon your life, no amount of failure can never bring you down. No failure can never bring you down. It doesn't matter, dozens mighty failure cannot bring you down, because God is bigger than anything that wants to bring you down. So this very hour, by the special grace of God, we want to go into severe prayer this very hour. I want to pray for you, and I know by the special grace of God, Jehovah will honor every word of this prayer in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. This is our hour, this is our destiny, this is our life, and I want to tell you, live your life. God has given you a beautiful life. It is now you to live your life. You are going to live your life in the way of the Lord. You are going to live your life gloriously, triumphantly, in gracefully, in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I command this very hour as a servant of the living God, I want to pray for everyone that is hearing me this very hour. I command as a servant of living God, I decree and I declare an unstoppable promotion to locate you this hour in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. When favor comes upon your life, hallelujah, unstoppable promotion comes upon your life. So I command this hour, let an unstoppable promotion, let it come upon your life in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. When favor comes upon your life, an unstoppable deliverance comes upon your life. You are delivered permanently in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. When favor comes upon your life, the grace of God comes upon into your marriage. So I decree and I declare, and I command unstoppable failure. Hallelujah, what can never be stopped. Hallelujah, failure that is coming to your marriage right now to be totally seized this hour in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I command unstoppable marriages right now to everyone that is looking unto the Lord for their fruit of the womb and their flesh of flesh. Today, by the special grace of God, God, we honor you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Because of the favor of the Lord is on ground, I command unstoppable peace. Hallelujah. No one can stop the peace of the Lord upon your life. The peace of the Lord that supersedes all understanding, I command to come to locate you this very hour in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I command unstoppable peace, let it locate you this hour. I command unstoppable blessing, let it look for you this very hour in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I command an unstoppable harvest to locate you right now in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Unstoppable fruit of the womb to support you this hour. If you have been yearning and crying to the Lord, Lord, hear me. Unstoppable fruit of the womb, let it come into your person this hour. Unstoppable glory that no one can stop it. You begin to shine, radiate in the glory of the Lord. I command to come upon your life this very hour in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I decree and I declare an unstoppable honor. Imagine Joseph was in the prison. Honor even checked him out. Honor supported him. Favor came down and honor embraced him. Today, by the special grace of God, I command an unstoppable honor upon your life this very hour in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I decree as sound of the living God, I command an unstoppable joy into your life this very hour in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Let unstoppable testimony, let it locate you this very hour in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Let an unstoppable growth, let it look for you right now. Joseph grew from 17 to 30, hallelujah, and became a king there. Today, hear me well, unstoppable growth, let it come upon your life. Unstoppable expansion, let it come upon your life in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. By the reason of the Lamb, I decree and I declare power of grace and favor that spotted Mephibosheth in Lodiba will look for you this very hour in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. The power of grace and the power of favor that spotted Mephibosheth in Lodiba will look for you and find you this very hour in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Grace and favor of God will override every decree that will not grant you joy in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I decree the grace and favor of the Lord to override every decree that will not grant you joy this hour in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Grace will speak in your disfavor in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Hear me very well. The favor of God, the grace and the favor of God will speak in your disfavor in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Where you have been disfavored, favor will speak for you. Grace will locate you there in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. The grace and the favor of God will terminate the power that is saying I cannot in your life in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, and we give you the power that I can do all things through Christ who strengthens you. I welcome the favor of the Lord to give you the power that you can do all things through Christ who strengthens you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. So I decree the favor of God to terminate the power that is saying you cannot in your life in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. From this very minute, from this very hour, Jehovah will roll away every stumbling block that is standing on your way to the top in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Hear me very well. Every stumbling block that was standing on the way of David to the top, Jehovah rolled away. In as much Jehovah rolled that away, God will roll away this very hour every stumbling block that is standing on your way to the top. Jehovah will roll it away in your life this very hour in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Hear me very well. I speak as a servant of the living God. From this very hour, from today, you begin to embark on a journey that will give you new life. Every journey you embark on right now will begin to give you new life, new spiritual momentum in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Wherever you go, every journey you begin to embark upon will begin to give you a new life, a new spiritual momentum in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. The Lord will give you a new name, a new identity that will bury any all ugly stories associated with your background. In the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ, hear me very well. Hey, Jacob had a story. Jacob ran away. He took his brother's blessing, but God granted him honor. God granted him favor. The story that associated with his background, Jehovah counseled it, and God gave him Israel. So today, by the special grace of God, Jehovah will give you a new name, a new identity that will bury all the ugly stories associated with your background. In the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ, I speak death to every evil growth in your life. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, let death come upon every evil growth in your life this very hour. In the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ, I command a release. Jehovah will release you. He release a measure of prosperity into your life this very hour that will swallow all history of poverty in your life. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, God will release unto you a measure of prosperity that will swallow all history, all stories of poverty in your life. In the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ, every story of poverty this hour is swallowed by prosperity. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, anyone that is doubting the ability to succeed will soon become your subject. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, whoever is out doubting your ability to succeed, hear me very well, they will soon become your subject. They will beg you. In the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ, I speak to your life right now. To everyone that is hearing me right now, I speak to your life, to every good thing that are dead in your life, to receive life back. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, you are moving into the third P this very hour, into palace right now. Recognition come, introduction into greatness comes upon your life from this very hour. So I decree and I declare, something better will come out of your bad situation. In the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ, wonderful thing will come out of your bad situation. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, they actually put Joseph in the pit, they put Joseph in the prison. Joseph actually excelled and he was actually put in the palace. Something great, something better will come out of your bad situation in life. In the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ, hear me very well. As many that are watching me right now, from this very minute, I'm not talking about tomorrow, I'm talking about receive the required courage to step into greatness God has ordained for you. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, hear me very well. I am not talking about tomorrow, I am talking about now. For now is the acceptable time, now is the day of salvation. You are being saved today, you are released today. So from this very moment, receive the required courage to step into greatness, into the things God has ordained for you. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, I speak godly things to begin to happen into your life. Let godly things begin to happen into your life, begin to happen in your situation right now. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, I command, as a servant of the living God, hear me very well. Every tight situation, let your tithes provoke heaven concerning it. Hey, to every tight situation, for those who are tithing, if you are not, you need to do it. A law have been told about it, you need to do it. So I speak as the sound of the living God. I command, in every tight situation that you are in right now, let your tithe provoke heavenly solution. In the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ, I decree an heavenly solution upon your life this very hour. In the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ, I retire every bankruptcy and vanity of flesh in your life this very hour. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, hear me very well. If you have been borrowing this very hour, you have entered into another level of greatness, another level of moving forward, another level of expansion. In the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ, from this very hour, I bind every spirit of error in your life this hour. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, you will no longer make mistakes that will cost you your life. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, hear me very well. I stand as a servant of the living God. In your life this very hour, I command the miracle that will surpass explanations to manifest in your life. Miracle that surpasses explanation, that people cannot explain. How could this happen? Even you yourself will say, I don't even have a clue. The miracle that will surpass explanation, let it manifest in your life this very hour. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, I command the miracle that surpasses explanations to manifest in your life this very hour. In the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ, I speak glory to replace your shame. In the name glory of the Lord, the favor of the Lord, the grace of the Lord, let it replace your shame right now. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, let it replace your shame right now. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, I speak glory, I speak favor, I speak grace to restore, to actually replace your shame right now. In the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ, by the reason of the anointing, by the power in the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ, hear me very well. I decree and I declare concerning your life, I command the resources of heaven to arise by fire and promote you. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ,
the resources of heaven. I command to arise by fire. I command them to promote you right now. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, your journey into greatness shall not be hindered or stopped. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, your journey into greatness shall not be terminated. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, you will not use your hand to terminate your journey into greatness. In the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ, your low diba will cry out, hallelujah, to be favored. Hallelujah. Your low diba will cry out to be favored this very hour in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Hear me very well. Mephibosheth's low diva cried out to be favored, and David heard the cry. Today, by the special grace of God, your low diba will cry out to be favored in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Your Zarephath will cry out to be favored in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. When the widow of Zarephath cried out, God honored, God heard her cry, and God sent Elijah. Hear me well. Your Zarephath will cry out in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ to be favored in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus. You have stepped into another glory. You have stepped into another grace in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. A place whereby God himself divinely introduced you into greatness in the name of the Lord Jesus. I want to tell you this very hour, God himself, actually divinely, God himself introduced you into greatness this very hour in the name of the Lord Jesus. You will no longer fall again. You will no longer faint again. You shall not be weary again. From glory to glory, from power to power, from strength to strength, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, attainment comes upon your life in the mighty name of the Lord. What you have been thinking about, and you have been crying, God, when is it going to come to pass? Hear me very well. You have entered your top pit. You enter the pit, you enter the prison, and you are in the palace right now. It comes at ease. Hallelujah. He hear what Pharaoh said to David. Pharaoh said to Jesus. Pharaoh said, only the throne will actually separate you and I. Hallelujah. He said, whatever you decree is settled. Hallelujah. A man that entered into another country became the prime minister. Hear me very well. If such a thing has never happened in your life, grace will elevate you. Grace will move you forward. Grace will promote you in the mighty name of the Lord God. The same way favor and grace promoted Esther. When Esther went before the king, grace will promote you. Grace will elevate you. Grace will increase you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. God said, my presence will go with you and my presence will give you rest. I command from this very hour the presence of the Lord to go with you and the presence of the Lord to give you rest all the days of your life in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. You will no longer labor in vain in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus. You will eat the fruit of your womb in the name of your person in the mighty name of the Lord. Every prosperity that God has actually assigned to you today by the reason of the anointing, begin to receive it right now. Let it locate you. Let it locate you. Let it locate you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Let it locate you wherever you are. Let the prosperity locate you. Let there be showers of blessing upon your person right now in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Your fasting shall not be in vain. It will not be in vain in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. From strength to strength, from power to power, from grace to grace upon your life in the mighty name of the, you will no longer fall. You shall no longer be ridiculed in life in the even if you are the least in your family. Gideon was the least in the family when grace spotted him. Gideon was the least in the family when favor located him, and favor called him mighty man of valor. He even questioned the angel. He said, our clan is the weakest in Manasseh. If your family, you are in the family that is the weakest ever, and you also, you are the weakest in your family, the weakest, I'm not saying wicked, weakest in your family, grace will locate you. The hand of the Lord will lift you up in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Jehovah will change your story and your situation in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Grace comes upon your life. Increase comes upon your life. Strength comes back unto you in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Grace locate you. It doesn't matter the position that you're in the family. If they have ridiculed you, they spoken about you, even in your presence, and they said, what can you offer? Gideon could not offer anything. He was just minding his business when grace spotted him. Gideon, mighty man of valor. Hear me well, by the reason of the Lamb. Jeremiah was known right from the womb. Grace spotted him. Today, by the power in the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ, grace spots you this very hour. You are being introduced into greatness right now in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And when the grace of God comes upon your life, you are elevated far above all principalities and powers. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. The eyes and the seas and the mouth that had ridiculed you will come to beg you. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. From this very hour, I command the grace of God never to leave you. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. From this very hour, you will not use your hand to destroy yourself. In the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you, Daddy. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Lord, I just want to thank you. I want to give you praise. You are God. You are not a man. Thank you for your faithfulness, O Lord. Thank you for this answered prayer. Thank you because in you, Daddy, we live, we move, and we have a being. All the glory, all the honor, all the adorations, Lord Father, we give back unto you. You are God. Sit in majesty. Still in the affairs of man. Thank you for what you're doing presently in our lives, O Lord. Thank you for introducing us into greatness. Thank you because your grace is upon our life. For Christ in us, the hope of glory. Thank you because you are Lord. You are Savior. Thank you as many as are hearing me this very hour, Lord. A change comes into their life this very hour in the name of Jesus. A turnaround locates them this very hour in the name of Jesus. They have entered into the last P. The last P that you've introduced them into greatness. Where no power can stop them. Because you have made a public spectacle of them. Triumphing over powers in victory. You are God. In this new week, in this new month, Lord Almighty, I just want to thank you. Because there shall be showers of blessings upon our persons. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Whoever is sick this very hour, O Lord, by his stripes, they are healed in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Whoever is down this hour, O Lord, I welcome the Holy Spirit to comfort the person right now. Speak to the person. Energize them, O Lord, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Every of your heart desire this hour, in order your heart desire is not to kill someone. Your heart desire is not about fighting anyone. May Jehovah honor every of your heart desire that is not unto sin in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you, Daddy, because you're wonderful. To you that be all the glory, to you that be all the honor. In Jesus' and authoritative name I pray. Amen. Hallelujah. I want to appreciate every single one of you. It's a privilege. I bless God for your life, for having me in your homes right now. It's a privilege and it's not a right. I appreciate you. I give you all the glory. And hear me very well. Lockdown is lockdown. Hallelujah. Lockdown is lockdown. The Bible says we should respect and honor the law of the land. Hallelujah. Lockdown is lockdown. It's for our own goods, our own protection and good. And as you are doing that, God in his infinite mercy will not allow any sickness or disease to enter into your house in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. For those who are privileged to go to work, if you are given that privilege, yeah, we bless the Lord. But we place safe and stay safe in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We've been having lockdown since Friday, but we are having the severe one from this very Thursday. Hallelujah. A severe lockdown that is going to be total lockdown for a month here in London. And I know they're having a total lockdown that started on Friday in France, and I was told it's going to be on Thursday as well. A total lockdown and a severe lockdown is actually taking place in France as well. Hear me well, lockdown is lockdown. Let us respect the law of the land. Hallelujah. If the law of the land is saying churches and every gathering must be closed down, close it down. One thing I know for sure, nobody can close the word of God down. Nobody can actually put a stop to online ministration. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Even if you can, if you're not privy to listen to online ministration, get your Bible and study the word of the Lord. Hallelujah. Lockdown is lockdown. And as you honor of the Lord, law of the land, may Jehovah honor you as well. In the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And it shall be well with you. Have a wonderful and a glorious day. God richly bless you. Extend my regards to your family. I love you all, and it is well with you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Hallelujah. So in your closet where you're praying, just put myself, my family in prayers with my beef for about 20 seconds. That will do, and we appreciate it in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. God bless you all. On Wednesday, by the special grace, I'm going to be online as well. That's going to be later in the evening, 8 p.m. London time, and 9 p.m. The French time, and 2 p.m. American time. That depends where you reside in America. I use the time of Chicago to do that. Those in Atlanta will be around 1 p.m. and it is well in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Enjoy the grace of the Lord. Enjoy the mercy of the Lord in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. God gave you and I the gift of life. Hallelujah. The gift of life was given to you and I by God. So it is up to us to give ourselves
yourself the gift of living well. You live well in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, and it shall be well with you. Let's try as much as possible to share this video. It is well with you in the name of the Lord Jesus. I love you all. Extend my regards to your family. I love them as well. It is well. God bless you richly. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen.